My dear friends, in our previous lecture, we have talked about indicators. Now, the next topic of this chapter is chemical reaction of acids. What are the important chemical reaction of acids? Or we can say this chemical reaction will exhibit chemical properties of acids. Here we have three important reactions. Reaction first is reaction of acid with reacting metals. Second, reaction of acids with metal carbonates and metal bicarbonates. And third, we know it very well, reaction of acids with bases. That is neutralization reaction. So let us start with the first chemical reaction, that is reaction of acids with reacting metals. Remember, both metals which are more electropositive than hydrogen are called reactive metals, or the metals which have more electron losing tendency if compared with hydrogen are called reactive metals. These metals have high electron losing tendency. So what will happen if such metals are made to react with acids? Here, displacement reaction will take place. A more reactive element will displace a less reactive element. So what will happen? If metals are made to react with acid, then metals will displace hydrogen from acid and form metal salt. Hydrogen, which is displaced by metal, will be removed in the form of hydrogen gas. Remember, hydrogen is a highly inflammable gas and it burns with pop sound. So if a gas on burning is producing pop sound, it shows that the gas released is your hydrogen gas or dihydrogen. So here we have one chemical equation, zinc with hydrochloric acid. Zinc being more reactive than hydrogen will displace hydrogen from here. So displaced hydrogen will be released in the form of H2 gas, and zinc after displacing hydrogen will combine with Cl to form ZnCl, zinc chloride. Same here, zinc with H2SO4. Zinc being more reactive than hydrogen will displace H from here. So H2 is released and zinc will combine with sulfate to form zinc sulfate. So H2 gas will be released in here. Zinc can be replaced by iron. Zinc can be replaced by aluminium. Zinc can be replaced by magnesium and so on. Remember, here we cannot use copper, silver, gold and platinum because these metals are least reactive metals. Their electropositive character or their electron losing tendency is less than hydrogen. So if reactivity of these elements, copper, silver, gold and platinum, is compared with hydrogen, then they are less reactive. So if we are using gold here with HCl, there will be no displacement reaction. Because here, now hydrogen is more reactive than gold. So gold will not be able to displace H from the acid. Now, the second one, reaction with metal carbonates and metal bicarbonates. Please remember, acids have the property to decompose carbonates and bicarbonate salts. Here we are using sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate. Both the compounds are basic in nature. they are facing salts. And we are reacting this compound with hydrochloric acid. So definitely there will be chemical reaction. A basic compound always reacts with an acidic compound. But remember here, two chemical reactions will take place simultaneously. First one is your decomposition reaction, and second one is your neutralization reaction, because we have taken a basic compound and an acidic compound. So due to decomposition reaction, what will happen? Due to decomposition reaction, carbon dioxide will form. All CO2 gas will be released. And release of CO2 will take place at a very fast speed. Our production rate of carbon dioxide is very high. So for that, we can use the term brisk effervescence. If release of gas or formation of bubble is taking place at a very fast speed during a chemical reaction, then we can use the brisk effervescence. So hydrochloric acid will decompose sodium carbonate, as a result of which carbon dioxide gas will be produced. It is the product of decomposition reaction. Now second one, that is the neutralization reaction. We know it very well, acid reacts with the base to form salt and water. So here, other two compounds will be sodium chloride salt in the water. So NaC and H2 are formed due to neutralization reaction, and carbon dioxide gas is formed due to decomposition reaction. Same here, sodium bicarbonate with HCl. Hydrochloric acid will decompose sodium bicarbonate, as a result of which carbon dioxide gas will be produced. It is produced as a result of decomposition reaction, and other two will be of salt and water. These two products are formed as a result of neutralization reaction. Now, chemical test for carbon dioxide, it's your lime water test. What is lime water? Lime water is a calcium hydroxide solution. When CO2 gas is passed through calcium hydroxide solution, remember it's a colorless solution, colorless plaster. So when CO2 is passed through calcium hydroxide, chemical reaction takes place as a result of which calcium carbonate is formed. Calcium carbonate is a white color compound and it is insoluble in water. So what will happen? Milkiness will appear. Milkiness will appear, or you will see colorless form will be converted to white color. So if formation of white color is there, then the released gas is your carbon dioxide. Remember, if more amount of carbon dioxide gas is passed, then milkiness will disappear, because calcium carbonate will further react with carbon dioxide and forms a water soluble compound, that is calcium bicarbonate. And the third one, reaction of acid with base, you know it very well, it's your neutralization reaction. Acid donates H plus ion, base donates OH minus ion, they will react and form H2 as a product. Another product will be your salt. So these are the three important chemical reactions. Thank you and have a good one.